will be investigating the assassination of Abraham Lincoln. The date, April 14th, 1865. Abraham Lincoln, his wife, and two other guests were in the Ford's Theater. They were seeing Our American Cousin. This is how the story unfolded. Our American Cousin. How are you?
I'm good, thank you.
I understand, Miss Poppins, that you were at the theater the night of this tragedy.
Yes, I was sitting below where the president's booth was.
Did you notice anything suspicious?
Well, I went and took a little venture to the powder room, and I saw someone going up the flight of stairs that led to the president's booth. But I was pretty sure that it was a security guard, so I wasn't very worried.
Do you go to the theater often?
Yes, all the time. Actually, John Wilkes Booth was someone that I had followed in his acting career, and I went to the theater many a time.
If you knew who John Wilkes Booth was, how did you not notice him on the stairs?
I only saw the back of his head, you see. If it was him, then I would have asked for his autograph or something.
Thank you, Miss Poppins.
You're very welcome.
Think of April 14th, when the president was assassinated.
Well, Mr. and Mrs. Lincoln invited me to go to the theater with them, and I was honored. And I went with my fiancé, and we were watching the proceedings, and I heard someone behind us, and I assumed that it was our bodyguard who was watching the president, but as it turns out, we heard a gunshot. And at first, many of us thought it was part of the play, until we looked over and saw that the president was collapsed in death.
That's unfortunate. Did you see the shooter at all?
No, I did not. I was watching the stage, which was in front of me, and I assumed that the shooter came from behind.
What did you do after the president was shot?
Well, I went over to go see if I could help, of course, and he was pretty much gone. And a couple of the men who were, the bodyguard had come, and he came back and he helped carry the president across the street to the boarding house, where he lay on his deathbed and died.
After the shooting, John Wilkes Booth has fled the city. He runs to a nearby barn for
John Wilkes Booth, surrender! Never! The troops are coming!
Left, 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 right, left.
God, he's getting away! No!
John Wilkes Booth is dead. Officer Corbett, you're the man who shot John Wilkes Booth.
Yes, I am.
What happened exactly?
Well, it was about 2 days after Lincoln's assassination. We
were on the lookout for him because we knew that it had been him. And we were, myself, I was down at the at the old barn, and I saw someone run into it, and I realized that it was Booth, and I thought I had to take action. So I drew my gun, and I told him that he had to come out or measures or desperate measures would be taken, and he didn't listen. So I called in my troops, and he eventually came out of the barn. And it was a very short chase around the barn and up to a residence, and I eventually shot him in the back of the neck, which paralyzed him, and we dragged him to jail.
Good. So what did it take to get Booth out of the barn?
I think it took the troops. I think that he definitely was scared by them.
And how do you feel about taking the president's assassin down?
I feel like I have done my duty to my country, and I will continue serving my great nation.
Go.
Priest Wilson, I understand that after the assassination of Lincoln, some churches in your area had memorial services for him.
That's true. My church gave a small dedication to the wonderful president who gave so many sacrifices for our country and led it through this hard civil war.
Since you live in Maryland, is it true that there are a lot of conflicts over the president being shot?
Yes, a lot of different people have different views on the assassination. There's those who mourn his death and there's those who celebrate it, thinking that it's a victory for the South. And there were towns that were celebrating his death, and the towns that were mourning it went and they attacked the towns that were celebrating it. So it brought a lot of conflict to our nation.
Thank you for being here.
Thank you.
So this was the investigative report on the assassination of Lincoln. I hope you thoroughly understand what went down on April 14th, 1865.